The dark side of olive oil. Shocking facts you've probably never heard. For years, you've been told olive oil is the healthiest fat on earth, the liquid gold of the Mediterranean diet. But what if I told you, much of the olive oil you're pouring on your salad, cooking with, or paying premium prices for isn't what you think it is? In fact, by the end of this video, you'll see why the truth about olive oil is far more disturbing than anyone admits. The dark secret of the olive oil industry. Most people don't realize this. Olive oil is a high-value product with a known risk of fraud. In fact, the European Commission and food crime operations, like OPSON, have identified olive oil, milk, and honey as commonly targeted products for fraud. Why? Because authentic extra virgin olive oil is expensive to produce. It requires harvesting olives at just the right time, pressing them cold, and bottling quickly before nutrients degrade. But the market is worth billions, and cutting corners is extremely profitable. So what happens? Instead of true extra virgin, many companies push blends, chemically altered oils, or oxidized leftovers. The shocking part? Most people can't taste the difference. And according to UC Davis Olive Center surveys, many imported olive oils on U.S. shelves at the time failed international extra virgin standards. Let's talk about that extra virgin label. Fake labels and the extra virgin scam. It's supposed to mean the oil was cold-pressed, unrefined, and free of defects. But multiple investigations, including one by the UC Davis Olive Center, found that a majority of imported supermarket samples tested then did not meet the extra virgin criteria, sparking major industry reforms. In other words, the label is often a marketing trick. Instead of fresh, antioxidant-rich oil, you're often buying degraded fat that's already lost its polyphenol antioxidants. And here's the kicker. Enforcement of international standards can be inconsistent, creating room for low-quality oils to reach store shelves. Producers know that the average shopper won't detect rancidity because by the time oil travels across oceans, sits in warehouses, and lands on store shelves, it already fails the freshness test. Yet the bottle still says extra virgin. Now let's uncover one of the dirtiest tricks in the industry. Adulteration. Adulteration is when cheap oils are secretly mixed into olive oil. Instead of giving you the pure healthy olive oil you're paying for, some producers dilute it with low-cost oils like soybean or sunflower. In fact, EU enforcement actions have documented real cases of this fraud. These are refined, high in omega-6, and linked to inflammation. Why would they do this? Profit. True extra virgin might cost $20 a liter to produce. Add half-refined seed oil, and the cost drops dramatically while profits soar. But here's the problem. These seed oils are more prone to oxidation and can generate reactive compounds when overheated, which may place extra stress on the body compared to stable monounsaturated fats. So while you think you're buying heart-healthy olive oil, you're really pouring inflammatory seed oil into your pan. And if mixing isn't enough, here's another disturbing tactic, chemical tricks and hidden processing. Have you ever heard about chemical deodorization? When olive oil turns rancid, it gives off a foul smell. Instead of throwing it away, producers use heat and solvents to strip out the odor. Then they remix it with a little fresh extra virgin oil to restore flavor and color. The end result? An oil that looks golden and smells fine, but has lost most of its antioxidants, vitamin E, and anti-inflammatory compounds. In other words, it's just empty fat. Chemical deodorization can strip flavor and antioxidants, leaving oil with much lower polyphenol content. Detecting these refined blends remains a known challenge for regulators, and without those polyphenols, you're not getting the protective benefits that make olive oil famous. Just a hollow product hiding behind a label. Now let's talk about how olive oil turns toxic. Heat, light, and storage problems. Olive oil is delicate. The antioxidants and vitamin E that give it health status are also extremely fragile. When you cook at high heat, frying, grilling, or even prolonged sautéing, the oil breaks down and forms toxic aldehydes. Studies show that prolonged or repeated heating of oils can produce aldehydes and other byproducts, but high-quality extra virgin olive oil is comparatively stable at normal cooking temperatures. But here's the thing. It doesn't take cooking alone. Light exposure, like sitting on a supermarket shelf in a clear bottle, speeds up oxidation. So by the time that bottle reaches your kitchen, some of the antioxidants, including alpha-tocopherol, may be lost and flavor degraded. And you won't even know it. Many extra virgin olive oils are best consumed within 12 to 18 months of harvest. And once opened, they should ideally be used within 2 to 3 months. That's why smaller bottles are often the smarter choice. Less time for oxygen and light to chip away at quality. Store in a cool, dark place and prefer smaller, darker bottles to reduce oxygen and light exposure. Now let's uncover oxidation and hidden rancidity. Oxidation is the silent killer in olive oil. Once oxygen interacts with the oil, it starts producing peroxides and free radicals. The problem is, rancid olive oil doesn't always smell bad. In fact, a sensory study published in Journal of Agricultural and Food Chemistry showed that most consumers can't tell the difference between fresh and oxidized oils. But your body can. Oxidized lipids can contribute to oxidative stress in the body, a process linked with cellular damage and cardiovascular risk. Research on lipid peroxidation suggests a connection between oxidized oils and markers of atherosclerosis, though this depends on the type and freshness of the oil. So while you think you're adding antioxidants to your salad, what you might really be adding is an invisible source of oxidative stress. Now let's talk about the invisible hitchhikers in olive oil. Pesticides, heavy metals, and contaminants. Large-scale olive farming uses heavy pesticide spraying to protect against mold and pests, but residues remain in the final oil. Studies in food additives and contaminants detected pesticide residues in some commercial oils, though most remained within EU safety limits. Add to that soil contamination. Olive trees can absorb trace elements from soil, including metals. While levels in retail oil are generally low, long-term accumulation of metals in food supply is monitored due to potential health risks. On top of that, packaging brings its own risks. So you're not just getting fat, you're getting a toxic cocktail. Now let's talk about why Mediterranean diet studies mislead. You're probably thinking, what about the Mediterranean diet? Isn't olive oil the secret? Here's the truth. Most Mediterranean diet research looks at the whole lifestyle. Vegetables, fish, nuts, walking, low sugar, and sunshine. Olive oil just happens to be part of that mix. When scientists isolate olive oil and test it alone, the benefits often shrink or vanish. For example, a Cochrane review concluded that results are mixed when olive oil is studied outside of the full Mediterranean context. Landmark trials show Mediterranean diets rich in vegetables, nuts, and olive oil reduce heart disease risk. Olive oil plays a supportive role as part of the overall pattern. Now, let's reveal what health dangers you're not told. Inflammation and immune stress. Fresh extra virgin olive oil contains anti-inflammatory compounds like oleocanthal. But many commercial oils lose these during processing or get diluted with omega-6 rich seed oils. Excess omega-6 drives arachidonic acid and pro-inflammatory cytokines, fueling chronic inflammation that harms blood vessels, joints, and the brain. Adulterated or oxidized oils may fail to deliver the anti-inflammatory protection of authentic, fresh olive oil. Heart health claims versus reality. Olive oil is often praised as heart healthy because replacing saturated fat with monounsaturated fat can improve cholesterol. But major reductions in heart disease occur only when olive oil is part of a Mediterranean-style diet rich in vegetables, fiber, nuts, and omega-3s, not from olive oil alone. Refined or adulterated olive oil, low in phenolics, can lose its protective effect. Brain fog and cognitive decline links. Olive oil is promoted as brain healthy, but oxidized or adulterated oils may do the opposite. Damaged fats produce aldehydes like 4-HNE, linked to oxidative stress and neurodegeneration, including Alzheimer's. Olive oil and cancer risk debate. Fresh olive oil contains antioxidants that may lower cancer risk, but once oxidized, it can generate harmful compounds like polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, PAHs, and acrolein. Adulterated or low-quality oils degrade faster, raising exposure to carcinogenic molecules. So, here's what you need to know. When is olive oil safe? Olive oil can be safe, but only under specific conditions. Fresh, cold-pressed, dark glass bottles stored away from heat and light retain beneficial polyphenols. Early harvest oils have higher antioxidants and more peppery flavor. Buy smaller bottles and use them up quickly after opening, ideally within 2 to 3 months for best freshness. Avoid high-temperature cooking with these oils. And if you're using it raw on salads or for dipping, make sure it's truly fresh. The next point you need to know is this. How do you spot real versus fake olive oil? The good news is, spotting fake olive oil isn't impossible. Look for harvest dates, dark glass bottles, and cold-pressed labels. High-quality extra virgin oil may become cloudy or partially solidify when chilled, and often has a peppery, slightly bitter kick in the throat, a sign of polyphenols. Flat, buttery, or neutral-tasting oil may indicate lower polyphenol content or aging. Now it's your turn. Which point surprised you the most? Leave a comment below, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Take care of your health, and I'll see you in the next video.